Hey guys, welcome back. मैं हूँ ज्योति, ये है श्रुति
और मैं हूँ श्रुति.
या श्रुति, we are going to a place where we haven't gone in a while.
Which is where?
I don't know if I've gone there with you.
Because we've been listening to all these songs, like we've been to all the songs, all different type of genres, all over the place. How can you say? ये कौन सी जगह है जहाँ हम नहीं पहुँचे हैं अभी तक?
Have you and I reacted to Nescafe basement?
Yes, of course we have.
Oh, we have. Okay, fine.
Early
but
on.
But it's been a while, na? So, okay, yes, we're going back there. The last season was 5, but now we're going to season 4 because there are quite a few songs in season 4 also that I never got to. And this one is called Fana and it's an original. So, it comes highly requested and recommended. I went back to my list of Nescafe requests and this is right on top there. It says it's an original melody by Sherry Khattak. So, Achha. Let's just get to it. I have high expectations from anything to do with Nescafe.
Yes, let's do this. Yes.
1, 2, 3, play.
Nescafe Basement, Season 4.
Oh, Wow.
Hey.
Wow. You know what I absolutely always love about Nescafe Basement? When you're listening to them, you really get that vibe of when musicians would probably, when they get together and they just jam together, and how if the jam session goes smooth and without any breaks, how it would sound like. Because the whole vibe that they've created is like that, where you are, it doesn't look doctored, it doesn't look, while it's very smooth, yes, like, you know, it has been planned, but yet the way the setup is, it just looks literally like everyone coming together and jamming together. But having said that, let's talk about Fana and that electric guitar sequence in the
they
end.
They all, my thing is, they all look so young, no, in Nescafe.
I know.
I'm just like, how? First of all, that only takes me by surprise every time. From the drummer to, I mean,
and they use the violin like a guitar.
So I think this was guitar and violin heavy arrangement. But the second part and towards the end, the drums really, you know, got into it and took off. So that took it to another sort of high. But if I had to pick just one thing, is that I felt the arrangement and the instruments sort of subdued the vocals in the song. To a large degree. It started off with the vocal being strong, but then it faded. And even when
was intentional. How in the end, when he was hitting a falsetto, he was almost sounding like an instrument himself. Like the voice was sounding like an instrument. So then, you know, the whole point where does is the instrument supporting the voice, or is the voice supporting the instrument, or is music being created with blurring the lines? That's how I looked at it.
So that's what I got, that it started off with the instrument supporting the voice, but it quickly faded into the other way around. But only part where he was saying these really strong lines with a lot of strong emotion, that's the only part I felt the vocals should have been complemented by the music where they weren't. Because I felt like us portion mein, the violin was doing such a dramatic thing, and the guitar as well, that the impact of those lines was not coming across for me. Because he was himself so into like going high in that zone, and I was like, I want to hear his voice.
You're right.
It's stronger. That's all. I love the arrangement and all that, but just that portion, they could have kept this one slightly. But otherwise, I mean, it says lyrics by Sherry and Zulfi, so I think he's helped finish the lyrics as well. It's a Sherry Hattak original, music produced by Zulfi. So, I mean, who is this guy? Where is he from?
Hasan Zafar, you're talking about? Which one are you talking about? Sherry Khattak.
Sherry Khattak, the lead vocalist. So, usse hi likha hai, uska hi gana hai. So, I'm just thinking, where is he from? Why have we not heard him before? And what else has he done? You know?
So, it's a song that leaves you very, like, leaves you moved, leaves you feeling that you have heard something amazing and that you want to just take 2 minutes to absorb what you've heard.
Yeah,
it's beautiful, very very nice.
No, but full props to all the violins. There were, I think, three: the guitarist, the bass, and the drummer, who just took off into his zone towards the end.
Keyboards also there.
For me, the song was like, how it made me feel was, it was very intense. You know, it wasn't that intense. Song.
I agree.
So unless I'm in that intense zone, I'll probably not listen to it. But I will just get to it to appreciate the arrangement and the music. Like all the musicians.
It leaves you also like that, which is what I'm saying. That right now, after listening to it, that intensity is passed on. I'm feeling like that, which is why I want to take 2 minutes to just, you know, absorb it. And then to get out of it also, it takes a little while. You know, because it's that intense. Yes.
It's that kind of song, But I could see it being in a movie, you know.
Like, you know, uske climax mein, ki yahan se wo daud ke aa raha hai, wahan se wo daud ke aa raha hai, kuch ho raha hai, and lekin conflict hai, aur ho nahi pa raha hai, aur peeche ye, yes, I can see it. Done and done. Hamare dimag mein hum film dekh bhi chuke hain.
I know.
Ho gaya khatam.
Right, and all that filmy notes, let us know what else we should get to. We'll see you in the next one.
Bye.